فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الإخوة المسلمون، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، مقولة لابن القيم قال فيها: من عرف الله بأسمائه وصفاته وأفعاله أحبه لا محالة. Whosoever gets to know Allah سبحانه وتعالى through his names, attributes and actions, he will certainly love Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وأيضا بمعرفة الله تكون الخشية. Also through the knowledge of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the fear, the exaltation of Allah is there. You will exalt Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قال تعالى: إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. Indeed, those who have khashya, fear of Allah, are those who are knowledgeable of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث الرهط أخرجه مسلم من حديث أنس: لأنا أعلمكم بالله وأشدكم له خشية. I am the most knowledgeable of you amongst you of Allah, and I am the most fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, wanted to mobilize our forces in order to learn the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said in a hadith that is agreed upon, hadith Abi Huraira رضي الله عنه: إن لله 99 اسما مائة إلا واحدة من أحصاها دخل الجنة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names out of all the names. The names of Allah are infinite, but out of the total number of the names of Allah, there are 99 names. Whoever does ihsa for these 99 names will enter Jannah. Ahsaha ya ikhwa right now in the ummah is ghannaha, really. That's all we know about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People singing it. When we have a wedding, huwa Allahu alladhi la ilaha al-malik al-quddus al-salam. Nice. Ahsaha is the deen, is the religion. And I want to live with you in the time I have with that word, ahsaha. Actually, the scholars came with four meanings for that word, ahsaha. I'm really interested in the last piece, and hopefully tonight, inshallah, I will explain more between Maghrib and Isha, the other three of ahsaha. But the fourth one, the scholars, they say, لكل اسم عبودية. Each name of Allah has a servitude. So for you to do أحصاها, you must exercise. لابد أن تتلبس بتلك العبودية. You must exercise that servitude if you really want to do أحصاها. When I came yesterday to your message, the word عباد الرحمن attracted me. I love الرحمن. What about the attribute of mercy, which was established in the Quran and in the Sunnah through two names, الرحمن الرحيم. And this name, يا إخوة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it equal to his name, الاسم العلم. The proper name for Allah, the deity who we worship is Allah. قل ادعو Allah. Call me Allah. But look, أودعو الرحمن. Or you can call me الرحمن too. He made it equal to him. وصفة الرحمة, the attribute of mercy is established. And there are a couple of things before we go into أحصاها that we should pay attention to, that Allah doesn't need us. ولذلك في القرآن, وربك الغني, look, ذو الرحمة. Your Lord is all sufficient, he doesn't need you, but in spite of this, he is merciful to you. Oh. ويأتي هذا المعنى أيضا, look, قل لمن ما في السماوات والأرض, قل لله. Say to them, O Muhammad, who owns what's in the heavens and what's in the earth? Listen, I want to establish this again. Allah doesn't need our worship. We need his worship, subhanahu. إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم. وحديث أبي ذر رضي الله عنه, حديث الإلهي, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم اجتمعوا على أفجر قلب رجل منكم ما نقص هذا من ملك شيء. If all of us, والعياذ بالله, mankind from Adam until the last soul born, even the jinn, would have the heart of the most wicked, this will not decrease from Allah his dominion, simply. فقل لمن ما في السماوات والأرض, say, ask them, who owns what's in the heavens and what's in the earth? The answer, قل لله, say to Allah. In spite of this, look, كتب على نفسه الرحمة. سبحانه. كتب. He made it mandatory upon himself to be merciful. شوف السنة يا إخوة, how the sunnah explains the Quran. في صحيح الإمام مسلم, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لما فرغ الله من الخلق كتب كتابا هو عنده فوق عرشه. When Allah finished creating the creation, he wrote a book. It's above his throne. اللي هو اللوح المحفوظ. One of the things written in اللوح المحفوظ, إن رحمتي سبقت غضبي. إن رحمتي, اللفظ الثاني, غلبت غضبي. My mercy overrides, precedes my anger. سبحان. And النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted us to really get that, the depth of that meaning, and he wanted this to penetrate the hearts. في صحيح البخاري, a scene, it sounds from the context of the hadith that it was right after a battle. حديث عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, from a distance they spotted a mother, she lost her baby, she's going like crazy. You know, a mother losing her baby, she doesn't know if the infant is alive or dead, so she's going around in the crowd. And she finally spotted her baby. She grabbed the baby next to her chest. And look at the scene now. A scene of love, of compassion. The Prophet looks at his companions. أَتَظُنُّونَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَةَ طَارِحَةً وَلَدَهَا فِي النَّارِ. Do you think this mother can ever throw her baby in hell? No, يا رسول الله, مستحيل, impossible. لله أرحم بعبدي من هذه المرأة وولدها. يا الله, Allah is more merciful to you and me than this mother to her baby. To her baby. رح وشوف شوف ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. My mercy encompasses everything. وذلك ورد في الأثر إن عمر بن عبد العزيز used to make this دعاء. اللهم إني أعلم أني لست أهلا لرحمتك. يا إخوة عبودية عالية هي سوء الظن بالنفس عبودية من أعلى العبوديات. That you don't praise yourself. Imagine عمر بن عبد العزيز. يعني there is a debate that he is the sixth rightly guided. يعني there is a legitimate debate. Look at his achievement for the Ummah. But in spite of this, he says, because of my sins, because of my shortcomings, عبودية هذه, servitude that you second guess yourself. You question your taqwa. You question your iman. Because the moment that you think of yourself, that's an entry of shaitan. And this is what got Iblis in trouble to begin with. But look at it. اللهم إني أعلم أني لست أهلا لرحمتك. Oh Allah, I know I don't qualify for your mercy. ولكني أعلم أن رحمتك أهل لي. But I know your mercy will include me. Why? لأنك قلت, because you said, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. My mercy encompasses everything. وأنا شيء. And I'm a thing. فلتسعني رحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله, let your mercy include me, يا الله. وفي إخوة, the hadith of the Bedouin who urinated in the masjid, you heard it so many times, for sure, inshallah. You know, the companions went after him. يعني urinating in the masjid is an odd thing to do. But the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what? Leave him alone, let him finish. That Bedouin came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he made this interesting dua. Out of al-Bukhari wa Muslim, so. النسائي بس authentic, اللفظ authentic. What did he say? اللهم ارحمني ومحمدا ولا ترحم معنا أحدا. شوف الرجل بسيط يعني. Oh Allah, have mercy on me and Muhammad and no one else. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم did not approve that. He said, تحجر يعني لقد حجر. He said, لقد حجرت واسعا. Allah says, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. And you're confining this to me and you. طيب, let's get to the essence now of the name الرحمن الرحيم and the attribute of mercy. How can I do أحصاها؟ ما هو الأحصاها now is becoming in the Ummah غناها. We only sing the names. الله الله حي الله الله. Oh, people singing it. لا, أحصاها هذا الدين كله. All the religion, أحصاها. How can you exercise the servitude of mercy? How can you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the two names of Rahman and Rahim? Number one, never despair from Allah's mercy. Never. Never. The moment that you do so, you have not worshipped Allah through that name. Oh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling upon you. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. لا تقرأ. عبد الله بن مسعود يقول عن هذه الآية, أرجى آية في كتاب الله, أرجى آية. If you want to read the Quran and you come up with hope, the largest amount of hope, read هذه الآية, اقرأ هذه الآية. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. Allah forgives all sins. سبحان الله. In four days, the night of the 15th of Sha'ban. Look at this. الحديث الوحيد, the only hadith that establishes something regarding the virtue of this night, في سنن ابن ماجه وفي صحيح الجامع, حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه. Look at the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. إذا كانت ليلة النصف من شعبان, today is the 11th of Sha'ban. Look at this. When the 15th of Sha'ban is here, يطلع الله إلى خلقه. Allah looks upon us in a way that suits His Majesty. I don't know how He looks at us, but in a way that suits His Majesty. He will forgive all of our sins except two. يغفر لجميع. شوف رحمة ربك. شوف. You don't have to do anything, but avoid those two. يغفر لجميع خلقه إلا لمشرك أو مشاحن. Someone who is engaged in shirk or someone who harbors hatred, animosity against another Muslim. شوف, that's all what you have to do. Clear those two. And get ready for the night of the 15th. Ramadan, just Ramadan. Ramadan is a step away. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the آثار رحمة الله, this is how the mercy of Allah is showing to you. شوف الصلوات الخمس, the five daily prayers, والجمعة إلى الجمعة, ورمضان إلى رمضان, Friday to Friday, ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات, they expiate your sins provided that you avoid the major sins إذا ما اجتنبت الكبائر. فتيأس لي من رحمة رب العالمين. Why? ما هو, I want to tell you something. This is like I said a minute ago. You know the name Iblis derives in Arabic from Al-Balas. Wal-Balasu huwa al-Ya'as. Al-Balas in Arabic means despair. Why Satan is in hell for eternity? He despaired from the mercy of Allah. والكافر, لماذا هو كافر? The disbeliever, why is he the disbeliever? Because he despaired from the mercy of Allah, بنص القرآن. شوف آية العنكبوت, والذين كفروا بآيات الله, شوف ولقائه, ليه? Those who disbelieved in the signs of Allah, in آيات الله and the meaning of Allah, why? أولئك يئسوا من رحمتي, because they despaired from Allah's mercy. فإياك يا ابن آدم, look at this, يا ابن آدم لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. يا الله, if you pile up your sins reaches السماء. ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك. في ما هي الرحمة هو تبدأ تعيش ليه? Why do you despair? Why? أو شوف يا ابن آدم, أو son of Adam, this is in the day of resurrection, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا. If you come to me in the day of resurrection with earth filled with sins, but with one restriction, you have not nullified your tawheed. لا تشرك بي, أتيتك بقرابها مغفرة, وهذا المعنى في القرآن, إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. Allah will not forgive that you commit shirk in the day of resurrection. If you commit shirk in the dunya and you go back to tawheed, خلاص, alhamdulillah. We don't have to kill one another like Bani Israel. All what you have to say is, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هذه رحمة رب العالمين. For the first step to worship Allah through the name الرحمن الرحيم, that you do not despair. Add to this, you don't make others despair. Especially if you're a speaker, especially if you make da'wa. Let people have hope. يعني two brothers في سنن الترمذي, one of them is righteous and the other one is off and on. You know, we call them washy washy, like the Muslims, you see them in the masjid for a week and then they disappear for a month, alhamdulillah they come back. So he's that type, he's not consistent. Yeah. He came to visit his brother, فسبحانallah, when he arrived at his house he found him committing a sin. This is the righteous one now. You know what he said to his brother? والله لا يغفر الله لك. شوف, by Allah, Allah will never forgive you for this. Allah revealed to the Prophet at the time, this is Bani Israel, من هذا الذي يتألى علي? Who is taking an oath on me? Let him know that I forgive, غفرت لأخيه وأحبطت عمله. Let him know that I forgiven the sins of his brother and his عمل, his actions are خلاص, gone. In vain now. He needs to start working over. يعني. يبدأ العمل من جديد. يستأنف العمل. وعندكم حديث قاتل الماء. The man who killed 99 souls. Originally he killed what? Killed 100 souls. Originally he killed 99. But then he came and asked, listen, do I have a chance for tawbah? يعني, imagine somebody comes to you and asking you this question. Listen, Sheikh, I killed 99 people before. Do I have a chance for tawbah? I mean, if you really have fiqh, understand? Sure. Even if there is no text there, you know. If you tell him no, what is he gonna do? I mean, come on, man. I hate to make you laugh in a khutbah, but it happened really somewhere in America. Somebody was delivering a khutbah like this, and I guess one of the crowd did not like what he's saying. In the middle of the khutbah, he stood up with a gun. Get down. So he looked at him and he said, أستغفر الله لي ولكم وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقيموا الصلاة. خلاص. فهذا رجل قاتل 99. You make him despair, it's over. Forget it. This is step number two. Step number three, brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it a condition for you to receive His mercy is to be merciful yourself. You must show mercy. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. Be merciful to those who are in earth. والله يا إخوة, if we just live the name الرحمن الرحيم, if we just exercise the servitude of mercy, a lot of our problems as an ummah will be solved. شوف, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من لا يرحم لا يرحم. If you do not show mercy, you're never going to be shown mercy. Where is the first place you should show mercy to? شوف, who? Your parents. What's happening to our parents? شوف, واخفض لهما جناح الذل. Why? من الرحمة. شوف, lower your wing of humility for them. يا إخوة, نبي الله جبريل and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they made this dua. One of them has to do with Ramadan too. خاب وخسر, a loser. The one who gets to live until Ramadan and he comes out unforgiving. Look at this other one. خاب وخسر. Both جبريل and the Rasul made dua. آمين يعني. خاب وخسر, a loser. من أدرك أبواه أو أحدهما ولم يدخله الجنة. That you come to this world and you find your father or both father and mother, the both parents or one of them alive and they don't become the reason for you to go to Jannah. شوف فقه ابن عباس في القرآن يقول لك إيه, ثنتان, there are three pairs in the Quran. ثلاثة نزلنا مقرونات, three pairs that you cannot divide them, you cannot separate them. Number one, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. You cannot separate the two, Quran and Sunnah, you can't separate them. هو اختار نبيا, ولذلك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد على طول أن محمد رسول الله. Look at the second one, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ. Look at the third one, أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. Be grateful to me and to your parents. If you really want to show gratefulness to Allah, the first place you should exercise this is your parents. وَقُلْ رَبِّ رَحَمْهُمَا. Oh Allah, have mercy on them. كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. When they took care of me when I was a little child. والله يا إخوة, if you have your parents alive, take advantage of this. والله, a lot of us have our parents dead. أقسم بالله, I bear witness, I wish I have my parents back so I can practice this. When it's too late, when you have them dead. Wallahi, when they die, you're going to regret every single second you wasted. Not to show love, respect, not to show mercy. بنص القرآن. Showing mercy to your children. يعني هذا الحديث, من لا يرحم لا يرحم. Whoever does not show mercy, he will never be shown mercy, was actually related when a companion who came to the Prophet ﷺ, whose name is Al-Aqra ibn Habis, and while the Prophet ﷺ was sitting down, Al-Hasan wal-Husayn approached him. So he grabbed Al-Hasan wal-Husayn and he hugged and he kissed them. Al-Aqra said to the Prophet ﷺ, أَتُقَبِّلُونَ صُبْيَانَكُمْ. Do you kiss your babies? يعني for some Arabs, this is a sign of تقدح في رجولاتك, يعني الراجل ما يقبلش العيال, يعني هذا فهم مش صحيح, يعني it's not correct. By Allah, look what he said, والله إنني عشرة صبيان. By Allah, I have 10 boys, ما قبلت منهم أحدا, I have not kissed any of them one time. In one other wording of this hadith, he said to him, وما أفعل إن كان الله قد نزع الرحمة من قلبك. What I'm going to do to you if Allah extracted mercy from your heart, that you don't kiss your baby, kiss your child. Come on. That's a natural thing. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he used to pray, Ya Ikhwa, Al-Hasan used to climb on his back. He used to prolong his sujood. Look at this. In order for Al-Hasan to enjoy his right. He would say that. شوف الرحمة. الرحمة لله. ما هو هذه الرحمة؟ ما هو this is living الرحمن, not الرحمن الرحيم. لا, هذا الرحمة, هذا هو أحصاها الرحمن. طب look at the divorce rate in the Muslim world has reached 60% in some Muslim countries. This is a crisis. This is a serious business. Wallahi, if we go back to the basis on which this relationship, this marriage contract was established to begin with, wallahi, all our problems will be solved. Look at it. نقرأ الآية. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَإِيه؟ فين الرحمة؟ المودة fades away. We know that after the second, third month of marriage, خلاص. الحب وبيبي والكلام ده بيروح. Gun with the wind. الرحمة should takes over. This is a sister Allah placed under you. You took her with a kalima. And you could divorce her with a kalima. فين الرحمة؟ ها؟ فين الرحمة؟ فين الرحمة for the sisters to give the brothers a hard time. So I don't want to get in your case here. Look at our problems. And wallahi, I'm not, I love you all, wallahi, I don't even know what's happening here. But look at the problem in our Muslim communities, whether smaller or larger size. شوف, if we just go back to the basics, to the, look at this. مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد. إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The likeness of the Muslims once it comes to the mutual love, compassion is like one body. If a limb in this body aches, the rest of the body will experience no sleep. محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار. This is in the battlefield. أشداء على الكفار, not when you make دعوة. In the battlefield, when he's a combatant. When you make دعوة, you have to be nice, you have to be cool. رحماء بينهم, but they are merciful amongst one another. حتى يا إخوة, showing mercy to the animals. Showing mercy to the animals. Don't we read that a woman, and guess what? She was what? A prostitute. She went to Jannah because of what? You think she loved the dog? No. She given a drink to a dog. She's shown mercy to this dog. This dog is experiencing what I experienced because she was thirsty herself. And she shown mercy to that dog. You know the greatest of all mercies to Allah, ya ikhwah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi a'azam rahma. Linnas. Wama arsalnaka illa rahma lil'alameen. You have not sinned but a mercy to all mankind. Let's live the name of Rahman, the name of Rahim. Let's exercise mercy towards one another. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل.
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.